Hello everyone and welcome back to your channel Lawpedia, and in today's video we'll be talking about National Green Tribunal. So I have tried to cover every aspect, whatever question that you may ask about National Green Tribunal in this particular video. Quickly moving on to the video. Starting the video with a very nice quote that I found over the internet that states that sooner or later we will have to recognize that the earth has rights to live without pollution. What mankind must know is that human beings cannot live without Mother Earth, but the planet can live without humans. So that's a very nice quote I found over the internet. Starting the video with this positive note, and the quote makes us understand the importance and the inevitable presence of environment in our lives from the moment we are born and till the time we die. So starting, what is National Green Tribunal all about? So firstly, established under the National Green Tribunal Act of 2010, it was established for effective and expeditious disposal of cases related to environmental pollution and conservation of forests, and of course other natural resources as well. Now the tribunal was basically set up for enforcement of any legal right relating to environment and giving relief and compensation to the persons and properties for matters connected with. So it's a holistic body which basically deals with every aspect of your environment law litigation that you can think about. And why have we created this separate judicial mechanism? Because of course we all understand the importance of environment. Of course we all must be aware about the fact that if environmental proceedings take long to dispose of, we are actually damaging the environment that much more. So we have set up this separate judicial mechanism in order to effectively deal with various aspects of the environment. So is slide mein humne basically ye samjha hai that why was National Green Tribunal set up, what is it all about, and what are the basic certain factors that you must know about it. Moving forward, some crucial points for you to note. So the tribunal shall not be bound by the procedure of Civil Procedure Code. Rather, it shall be guided by the principles of natural justice. Further, the tribunal acts as a dedicated jurisdiction to provide speedy environmental justice. Now, another important question that you may ask over here is speedy justice delivery. How? So the tribunal is mandated to make an endeavor for disposal of applications or appeals finally within 6 months of filing of the same. So there is a specific duration within which the tribunal should act on the appeals or applications made under it. That's how speedy justice delivery mechanism is to function. The next important point is the tribunal's order are binding, and it has power to grant relief in the form of compensation and damages to the affected person. That's how it acts as a holistic mechanism of justice delivery, and speedy one as well. Now, very important question, who may submit a case to the tribunal and what sort of cases are heard? Since environment litigation is very important, so any person seeking relief and compensation for environmental damage involving subjects in the legislations mentioned in Schedule 1 of the National Green Tribunal Act may approach the tribunal. So now next question would be, what is this Schedule 1 all about? What kinds of acts or legislations have been included in Schedule 1? So now if your matter relates to, pertains to any of the following given below statutes, you can approach to the National Green Tribunal for seeking damages or seeking compensation, restoring whatever rights of your person or yourself was violated. So these are the wide variety of legislations that have been included in the National Green Tribunal's ambit. And you would now observe that almost every aspect of the environment law per se has been included in the Schedule 1 of the National Green Tribunal Act 2010. Moving forward, now very interesting question is, do I need to engage in an advocate to approach the tribunal? So the answer to the question is No, engaging an advocate is not necessary. The aggrieved parties may approach the tribunal in person by submitting an application in the required format. So now this application can be submitted online as well. That's what I am including in the description box below, the basic mechanism how you can approach the tribunal. Are the decisions of the tribunal final? Another very crucial question. So the tribunal has the power to review its own decisions, and if this fails, the decision can be challenged before the Supreme Court within 90 days. The next authority in this particular case would be Supreme Court of India, that too within the period of 90 days. So that's it for today's short, simple video. I hope you did understand almost every aspect related to your National Green Tribunal. I hope it was a fruitful video. And if you have any doubts, again, please feel free to put them down in the comment section below. And as we always say, till the next video, stay home, stay safe, and keep learning.